Now, amongst those equivalent conditions related to equilateral triangle, the last one, which is determinant of 1, 1, 1, z1, z2, z3, z2, z3, z1 is equal to 0. I mean, this implies z1, z2, z3 are vertices of equilateral triangle. Now, in general, a11, a12, a13, a21, a22, a23, a31, a32, a33. Suppose this is called determinant. Determinant. The numbers arranged in an array matrix with two vertical is called determinant, and this is exactly a11. हाँ बिल्कुल, हाँ बोला बोला। आठवी मैं काय करू सांगू का तोंडाने? हाँ थांबा थांबा, होल्ड करा एकच मिनिट। I mean, presently you can say that something like this is exactly equal to this. Okay. And now I have expanded this determinant using first row. So the idea is if you are using this, then the remaining 2 by 2 determinant, I hope you are aware of remaining how to expand 2 by 2 determinant, this into this minus this into this. This is principal diagonal. Principal diagonal multiplied by the other diagonal. Now, normally, if you, when you can expand this using row or any column, but then in sigma notation, let me write down sigma how do I write sigma the I mean row numbers are aij is the entry. I mean, this determinant is also represented. This is a matrix aij where ith row and jth column. Okay, so this is sigma. And it is difficult to write these brackets. Okay. So therefore, now therefore another notation is there which is called cofactor and adjoint. So it is a theory of determinants. So basically, if you are suppose expanding using the say second row in, so let me just explain you how to expand, how much is the value if we expand using second row. If we expand using second row, it will be minus 821 into a12 a33 minus a32 a13 plus a22 inside bracket a11 a33 minus a31 a13 and minus a23 inside bracket a11 a32 minus a31 A12. If you observe, all the terms in this and all the terms in this are going to be identical. So basically, how will you decide whether to take plus or minus? The idea is, if I plus j is even, so minus 1 raised to I plus j is the coefficient of this. If it is even, it is plus. If it is odd, it is minus. Here it is odd, it is minus. Here it is even, therefore plus. Odd, therefore minus. So minus 1 raised to I plus j, that is what is the coefficient that you are supposed to consider, which will give you plus or minus. And then ignore. Suppose I am expanding using the second row, then you ignore second row and ignore second column. These entries are ignored. So if A21, if you are writing A21, then ignore first column, second row, and consider the determinant. Therefore, these four entries will be there. Sorry, what I was saying is, suppose you are writing A21, that means second row, first column. So ignore second row, first column, and then it is a 2 by 2 determinant, write down the value. If you are writing 2 by 2, then ignore second row, second column, then it is a 2 by 2 determinant, write it. Second row, third column, 2 by 2, remaining determinant is 2. That is how you are supposed to expand. Therefore, if we want to expand this determinant, what we will get here is 1 into z1, z2 minus z3 square minus 1 into z1 square minus z2, z3 plus 1 into z1, z3 minus z2 square. Okay. So we get z1, z2 plus z2, z3 plus z3, z1 minus z1 square minus z2 square minus z3 square, and you already know that this is equal to 0. Therefore, this determinant is equal to 0 is yet another equivalent condition, because it means exactly the same thing. It means exactly the same thing. Okay, so further to this, after we understand that these are all equivalent conditions, how do we utilize the similarity of two triangles to deal with the equilateral triangle? The idea is that. So now suppose we want to show some triangle, equilateral triangle. Then what did we do in earlier geometry problems? That we have shown the rotation to be equal to minus omega square. Okay, so suppose I want to show that this z1, z2, z3 is equilateral, then we have shown that z3 minus z2, when rotated to become z1 minus z2, z3 minus z2, when rotated to become z1 minus z2, we have shown the rotator to be minus omega square. So this is using rotators, and we have created all the rotators. However, we can write this, and we will arrive at the same conclusion. However, we can write, I mean, equivalent condition number D. If we write equivalent condition number D, it is similar to this. So Z1 minus Z2 upon Z3 minus Z2, I am comparing this with equilateral triangle 1 omega omega square. Okay. So Z1 minus Z2, Z1 minus Z2 is 1 minus omega upon Z3 minus Z2. Z3 minus Z2 is omega square minus omega. Let us see what this rotator is now. Can we simplify this and find out whether it is something similar to this or not? How do we simplify it? Omega is cube root of unity. So how do we simplify this now?
सर खालतून ओमेगा कॉमन काढायचा.
खालतून ओमेगा कॉमन काढला तर आतमध्ये राहतं ओमेगा मायनस ओमेगा मायनस वन, आणि वरती minus 1 common kadla to omega minus 1. So if they get cancelled and you get minus 1 upon omega, minus 1 is minus of 1 is omega cube upon omega, you end up getting minus omega square. This is what is this. That is what we had already done earlier. Okay. Only thing is that because it is equilateral triangle, you need not have to worry about the orientation, either inversely or directly should work. However, if you are really ending up showing some similar triangles somewhere, and if we wish to use complex numbers, then you have to be little careful about whether to go for direct similarity or inverse similarity. Okay, so that is what is the application. Is everything understood? Okay, next problem. Now they are going to be miscellaneous problems where we are supposed to apply the concepts that we have learned. Also, I have sent you a booklet of complex numbers in which there is not much theory which is discussed. We have discussed theory quite a lot, but there are question papers, previous year question papers are available in that booklet. And for practice, not only you should solve the earlier problem set that I have sent you, but also you should solve the booklet question. Let P0, P1, P2, Pn minus 1 be regular polygon. Inscribed in a circle with radius 1. Prove that. P0 P1 into P0 P2 into P0 P3 into dot 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 P0 Pn minus 1 is equal to n. And question number 2. Sine pi by m into sine 2 pi by m into sine 3 pi by m into dot 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 sine n minus 1 pi by n is equal to n upon 2 raised to n minus 1. And 3, sine pi by 2n sine 3 pi by n into sine 5 pi by m into sine 2n minus 1 pi by m by 2n equal to 1 over 2 raised to n minus 1. Take your time. As and when you complete your proof, try to show me. I will try to read. Even if it is not possible, I will pretend that I have read your proof and it is correct. Okay. Okay. I'm sure you must have, few of you must have solved it, but it is going to be difficult for me to check. Therefore, let us go and start directly. Now this is a regular polygon inscribed in a circle with n sides. So the correct setup for us is going to be vertex number 1, first vertex. Suppose this is radius is 1. This is 1, 0, and it is n-sided regular polygon. So this is your alpha. This is your alpha square. And this is going to be your alpha raised to n minus 1. These are the roots of z raised to n minus 1 is equal to 0. So alpha, alpha square, alpha dot dot dot, alpha raised to n, and for one real root, which is 1. Now this question is distance. This is P0. This is P1. This is P2, Pn minus 1. What is said is this distance multiplied by this distance, multiplied by this distance, multiplied by this distance, multiplied by this distance. All these distances, product of these distances is going to be equal to n. That is what we are supposed to prove. Okay, so basically, what is P0, P1? P0, P1 is absolute value of 1 minus alpha. What is P0, P2? It is absolute value of 1 minus alpha square. You can call this as alpha square, or you can call this as alpha 2. You can call this as alpha n minus 1. And because first root is a primitive root, always all the possible powers of the first root will generate remaining all roots. So we understand that well, and therefore we are interested in knowing what is 1 minus alpha, what is 1 minus alpha square, absolute values. Okay, so algebra is going to be like this. Z raised to n minus 1 can be factorized as z minus 1 into z minus alpha into z minus alpha square dot 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 z minus alpha raised to n minus 1. This is the factorization of this polynomial in complex numbers. And again, it can be factorized by our old method as z minus 1. And what is actually, what is the product of all these? We know this product. It is z raised to n minus 1 plus z raised to n minus 2 plus dot 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 plus z raised to 1 plus z raised to 0. This is going to be the product of these n minus 1 brackets. Leading coefficient will be z raised to n minus 1 if chosen from every bracket. करेक्ट लिहतोय मी आहे सगळं बरोबर चाललंय अरे आर यू देयर
यस सर
यस
यस
ओके सो नाउ यू विल ऑब्जर्व दैट दिस इफ वी दिस इज व्हाट इज गोइंग टू बी इक्वल टू 0 इफ वी पुट झेड इज इक्वल टू 1 अदरवाइज इफ वी पुट झेड इज इक्वल टू 1 दिस इज व्हाट वी आर इंटरेस्टेड इन झेड इज इक्वल टू 1 दिस इज व्हाट वी आर इंटरेस्टेड इन Therefore, from here, we take the identity of these brackets. Okay. And z minus 1, z minus 1 is cancelled from both sides before substituting 0. Before substituting z is equal to 1. If z is equal to 1, then we cannot cancel. If z is not equal to 1, we can cancel. And therefore, we know that product of these many brackets is this. Anyway, this identity Anyway, this identity is true. So this is correct. Now, put z is equal to 1. Therefore, we get 1 minus alpha, 1 minus alpha square, dot, 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 1 minus alpha raised to n minus 1 is equal to 1 plus 1 plus dot, 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 plus 1. How many 1s are there here? N. If they start from 0 and end at n plus n minus 1. So total n 1s are there. At this point, we take absolute value of both sides. Taking absolute value of both sides, absolute value of product is product of absolute values. Therefore, mod 1 minus alpha, mod 1 minus alpha square, dot, 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 mod 1 minus alpha raised to n minus 1 is equal to mod of n, which is n. So this is P0P1 into this is P0P2 into dot, 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 this is P0Pn minus 1 is equal to n. This is the first identity that we are looking for. Okay. Now, have you all understood any doubt, difficulty in this? Everything is there in front of you. Problem number 2. Now, this is very important. If you consider a root alpha raised to k, where k is an integer, then that is cos, bola, what is cos plus I sine form of alpha raised to k? How much this angle will be here? We have total 2 pi and it is divided in n. So 2 pi by n is first angle and taking total k angles, right? So 2 pi by n, 2 pi k by n plus I sine 2 pi k by n. So any of the roots, nth roots, kth nth root of unity, kth nth root of unity will look like this. Yes or no? Kth nth root of unity will look like this. Okay. So, if we do 1 minus alpha raised to k, that is basically these brackets, one of the brackets I am considering now, which will be equal to 1 minus cos 2 pi k upon n minus I times sine 2 pi k upon n. You observe each and every step, otherwise suddenly you will start not understanding these things. Okay, have you understood this at this stage? Okay. Now sine 2 theta and 1 minus cos 2 theta. Can we apply some formula here of trigonometry? This is 1 minus cos 2 theta. 1 minus cos 2 theta is 2 sine square theta. 1 minus cos 2 theta is 2 sine square pi k by n. That is this. And how much is minus I times 2 sine 2 theta? 2 sine pi k by n cos pi k by n. Do you understand this step? Very good. Now there is something common here. 2 sine pi k by n inside bracket sine pi k by n minus I cos pi k by n is 1 minus alpha raised to k. Okay, that is one of the brackets in terms of k we are writing, generalized. Now, if I take absolute value of both sides, absolute value of 1 minus alpha raised to k is going to be absolute value of 2, which is 2, into absolute value of this sine pi k by n. What is the absolute value of this? It is 1.
1.
Real part square plus imaginary part square, square root is 1. Okay. So now we have reached this identity. Now let me write down this implies, this implies, this implies. Now, final point. So if you replace, I want to write it like this. We already know n is equal to what? Absolute value of 1 minus alpha. So k is equal to 1. Absolute value of 1 minus alpha into absolute value of 1 minus alpha square dot 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 into absolute value of 1 minus alpha raised to n minus 1. This is what we already know from result number 1. But now absolute value of alpha is 2 into mod. Now let us crush check. What will happen to this mod? If I put k is equal to 1, it is pi by n. Pi by n is going to be, voila. Will all these angles be above x-axis? Will pi k by n, k goes from 1 to n minus 1. Will this quantity be above x-axis, this angle?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Therefore, what will be the sign of that angle? Always?
Positive.
Positive.
Yeah. Do you understand this? This is first. K is equal to 1, you are here. K is equal to 2, you are here. K is equal to 3, you are here. Pi by n. This is 2 pi by n, actually. This is first is 2 pi by n. Yeah, I mean, k is going to be less than n. Therefore, this quantity is less than pi. Correct? And therefore, sine of something which is less than pi is always going to be positive. Therefore, I can ignore this absolute value sign here and write it as sine pi by n, that is for this first modulus. What will be for second modulus? 2 sine 2 pi by n. What will be for third? What will be for last? 2 sine 2 into n minus 1 pi by n, n minus 1 pi by n, bracket complete. Okay, so what is this? This is what you were supposed to prove. N is equal to sine pi by n, etc. So this is your LHS. So I put everything else to RHS. So this is 2 raised to, how many 2 raised to, how many brackets are there? Total n minus 1. So 2 raised to n minus 1 into pi sine pi k by n, k goes from 1 to n minus 1. And therefore, LHS is equal to n upon 2 raised to n minus 1. Prove. Okay, I will shrink it, you copy it, you ask me doubt, we will explain, and then doing third is not very difficult. Everything is there in front of you now. I pause it for a couple of minutes to go. Okay. When we are solving the third problem, we should compare it with the second problem. In second problem, all the sine angles were 1 to n minus 1, pi by n, continuous. Here they are, first of all, denominator is 2n and 1 to 2n minus 1, but jumping, maybe we can call them odd, odd multiples of pi by 2n. Okay, so now if we compare this problem with this problem, what is the first thing that we should do is, instead of considering the n-sided polygon, we should consider 2n-sided polygon. 2n-sided polygon. So this is 1, 0. You will have first root. Let us call this root as alpha. Second root as alpha square, and the last root is alpha raised to 2n minus 1. So this is how many sided polygon we are considering now?
2n
sided polygon. Therefore, each angle here will be 2 pi total angle divided by 2 pi is the total angle and 2n sided polygon. Therefore, total side is 2n. Therefore, each angle will be pi upon 2n, pi upon n, first angle. Right? In earlier case, it was pi upon 2n. Now it is, in earlier case, it was 2 pi upon n. Now it is pi upon n. That is the difference. Correct? Okay, so if that is the case, then how can we use the first problem to solve the third problem? Now what will be the, suppose we have first problem for 2n sided polygon, what will be the result? Suppose we have first problem for 2n sided polygon, then what will be the result? First problem. First problem implies 1 minus alpha into 1 minus alpha square into dot 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 into 1 minus alpha raised to 2n minus 1 is equal to z raised to 2n minus 1 plus z raised to 2n minus 2 plus dot 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 plus z plus 1. How many numbers are there here now? 2n. Correct. So if we substitute, z is equal to 1 and take absolute value of both sides, then we will get absolute value of 1 minus alpha into absolute value of 1 minus alpha square dot 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 into absolute value of 1 minus alpha raised to 2n minus 1 is equal to 2n. That is what we will get, right? And then what is our okay, now this is 2n. However, now we are not going back and doing all things again. However, this is alpha square now, which was alpha earlier. This is alpha raised to 4 now, which was alpha square earlier. Yes or no? Are you atote ka?
Yes, sir.
So this is half angle of this. This was our earlier angle. Now this is half angle. Therefore, this was alpha, which is alpha square now. This is alpha square, which is alpha 4 now. Therefore, 1 minus alpha square. Out of, let me write down few more here so that we will be able to figure out what I mean to say. Absolute value of 1 minus alpha, absolute value of 1 minus alpha square, absolute value of 1 minus alpha cube, absolute value of 1 minus alpha fourth, dot dot dot, absolute value of alpha, absolute value of 1 minus alpha raised to 2n minus 2 into absolute value of 1 minus alpha raised to 2n minus 1 is going to be equal to 2n. Correct. Out of which
consider the second result for 2n, and then all the even angles will become like sine pi by n, sine pi by.
So now these even angles are going to be n into 1 minus alpha cube dot 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 1 minus alpha raised to 2n minus 1 is equal to 2n. This is what we have got. If there is any doubt, you can ask me again, but otherwise this is correct. So now the product of 1 minus alpha cube, 1 minus alpha raised to 2n minus 1 is equal to 2. Brothers, am I correct? Yes, hopefully it should be correct. Now we have to calculate the same we have done for second result. Now we have to do it for this. How do we go about it? We have odd powers of alpha. So 1 minus alpha raised to 2k plus 1. This is odd power of alpha. Is going to be equal to 1 minus cos 2k plus 1. Bola. 1 alpha raised to 2k, that is that root, odd number root. So that number multiplied by.
Sir, this is 2k plus 1 by j.
अरे हाँ 2k प्लस 1 पाहिजे. नहीं मी जरा त्याचा कोएफिशिएंट काय ते शोधतो जरा तो करूया 2k प्लस 1 नो इशू. 2k प्लस 1 इज अ मल्टीप्लायर एंड व्हाट इज द बेसिक एंगल
फॉर
इज गोइंग टू बी 2 पाई बाय n की 2 पाई बाय 2n दैट इज व्हाट इज द क्वेश्चन. Yes, pi by n pi j.
Oh, pi by n.
Say for example, I am looking at this itself. First one, k is equal to 0. If I substitute k is equal to 0, I should get pi by n. If I substitute k is equal to 0, I should get pi by n. Okay. So 2k plus 1 pi by n, that is cos, plus or minus I sine 2k plus 1 pi by n, right? Again doing the same work over here that we did earlier. Actually we did not do it, but we can say that this result is achieved, but now let us do it anyway, recording is going on. So this is 1 minus cos 2 theta. So 2 sine square 2k plus 1 times pi by 2n divided by 2 minus I times 2 sine 2k plus 1 pi by 2n cos 2k plus 1 pi by 2n. Okay, this is equal to 2 sine 2k plus 1 pi by 2n outside and common, and inside sine 2k plus 1 pi upon 2n minus I cos 2k plus 1 pi upon 2n. Okay, understood. Now this is 1 minus alpha raised to 2k plus 1. All these people sitting here are of the form 2k plus 1. Okay, and therefore taking absolute value of both sides, we get this is equal to 2 into absolute. Now what is the faith of this? Is this again going to be positive? So far this is starts from 0 and ends at n minus 1. Numerator, this upon this is going to be less than 1, and therefore this quantity again is going to be positive, and therefore you have sine 2k plus 1 pi by 2n, and again absolute value of this is 1, and therefore you have a result LHS is equal to, how many terms are there? Now can you tell me how many terms are there here? They will be n terms, because we have removed n terms. Total 2n, nahi, total terms kiti hote ithe agodar
2n
plus 2n pasun suru te 2n minus 1. How many total terms were there here?
2n minus 1.
2n
minus 1 total terms were there, out of which we have removed how many? N. Therefore, how many terms are remaining now here? N minus 1. These are total n minus 1 terms. Therefore, 2 will be generated how many times? N minus 1 times. And then it will be product of sine 2k plus 1. No, LHS is equal to n. I'm just taking the product. 2k plus 1 into pi upon 2n. K goes from 0 to n minus 1. At n minus 1, this quantity is going to be 0. N minus 2 by n. Parana 0 dakte na mi, k is equal to 0. And I want total n minus 1 terms. Therefore, this index is going to be n minus 2. I mean, you need to spend good amount of time to understand all these k business. I should have taken 2k minus 1 here. And k starts from 1. Then this is n minus 1. Okay, anyway, I mean, you are mature enough to understand this. And I'm not making any mistake. If there is a mistake, you tell me. This is n minus 2, and therefore this ratio is always less than 1. And therefore the sine of something less than 1 times pi is always above x-axis. Hence it is always positive. And therefore, now this is what is your LHS, which is equal to 2. That is what we have done. And therefore LHS is equal to 2 upon, that is what we are supposed to prove. What are we supposed to prove? LHS is equal to 2 upon 2 raised to n minus 1. That is 2 raised to n minus 2 upon. Sukla Vintan.
Sir, upon n minus 1 terms card le. 2 n minus 1 minus n minus 1. Sir,
n terms paije. 2 n minus 1
hai. Sir, the 1 minus alpha into 1 minus alpha cube. The total n terms hai.
सर कारण की आपण 2 4 6 टिल 2n minus 2 काढले तर टोटल आपण n minus 1 टर्म्स रिमूव्ह केल्या नॉट n.
ओके ओके, सो दीज आर रिमूव्ह, n minus 1 टर्म्स आर रिमूव्ह, and therefore n terms are remaining. Barobar hai?
Ho sir.
1, 3, dot, 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 2n minus 1. That means we have total n terms. This is arithmetic progression, na? 1, 3, 5, 7.
Yes, sir.
With first term A and yes, common difference n minus 1 times 2, which is equal to 2n minus 1. Okay. So total number of n remaining. Therefore, this should be n. Therefore, 2 upon 2 raised to 2 upon 2 raised to or each 2 raised to n, which is 1 upon 2 raised to n minus 1. Me evada detail ekadi chodalo anta antha. I am trying to be very systematic this year.
Apeksha direct 2n upon 2 raised to 2n minus 1 divided by n upon 2 raised to n minus 1 kela chayal.
Oh, direct asta, but yacha madhe gammat hai na, sagal karayla pahije vyavasthit ani te chukta na, ithe n minus 2 pahije, ithe 0 at suru jala hai vagare vagare. So you, I mean, you get complete clarity about what you are doing instead of jumping to the conclusion. You can do it this way. Understand whole situation. Now if it comes again with some other form, say for example n is equal to 12, n is equal to 15, then you have everything ready with you. You can directly write the answer. Okay, so I should give you now a couple of small problems.
Sir, the light blue madhe je lihle te even terms kase cut kele te ajun ekda samjva na.
Even terms kase cut kele te samjav. इथे कुठे लिहिले मी सगळ्या इव्हन टर्म्स लिहिलेत बघितलं. आता नाव यू कन्सिडर, वाय शुड यू कन्सिडर 1 मायनस अल्फा रेस टू 1? इफ वी कन्सिडर ऑल पॉवर्स ऑफ से के रेस टू 1, के रेस टू 2, के रेस टू 3, के रेस टू 4, डॉट डॉट डॉट, के रेस टू 2 एन मायनस 1, हे सगळे लोक आहेत. अरे यातले मी इव्हन पॉवर वाले सगळे हाकलतो. That is what we have done here. So what remains is k raised to 1, k raised to 3, k raised to 5, dot dot dot, k raised to 2, n minus 1. Hey, loka sagale rahnar ahet. How many of them are there now? If we count, they are n in numbers. How many of them we have removed? N minus 1. Total how many were there? 2n minus 1. Why 2n minus 1? Because we are considering z raised to 2n minus 1 is equal to 0. Out of which z is equal to 1 is one root, which we are cancelling from both sides. Therefore, how many roots are remaining now? Z raised to 2n minus 1 roots are remaining.
Sir, the kaala pantanna hakalyan antar tanna n ne replace kele na n ne.
Ah, to n hota to kadun takla ikadcha. All of them were multiplying to n, na? Because that is another regular polygon which is part of this bigger polygon. Therefore it is free from n now, because it will always see, if you have even sided polygon, say let us have octagon. This is regular octagon. Now regular octagon is having one regular four-sided gon square within it. So if you remove it, then you are left with alpha, alpha raised to 3, alpha raised to 5, and alpha raised to 7. Because you have removed alpha raised to 2, alpha raised to 4, alpha raised to 6. These guys are gone, and anyway this we have removed.
Yes, sir.
So what remains is alpha, alpha cube, alpha fifth, alpha 7. So every time you have a even sided polygon, you will definitely have something like this. And we were having definitely even sided polygon now. It is 2n. And therefore we can always delete the n sided regular polygon from it. I mean, delete means divide. Delete means actually what you are doing here is, we are dividing all these roots by question number 1 LHS. And therefore, question number 1 RHS is n. And therefore, we get this identity. This is nice way of representing. This is new numerator. Question number 3 is new numerator. And new numerator in RHS, we divide question number 1 LHS, question number 1 RHS, we get this identity. And then we process this identity. Is that fine? Very good. Okay. Now, a couple of simple problems. Evaluate 50%, 55%. Which color I did not use today? Violet. Evaluate. Sigma. K goes from 1 to 10. Cos. 2 pi by 11 k. This is one, and quickly you can solve the second also. Sigma k goes from 1 to 6 cos of 2 pi upon 13 times k. You can show these answers. Answer for first is minus 1. Answer for second is minus 1 upon 2. Okay. Third, sigma k goes from 1 to 10 sine 2 pi k upon 11. Fourth, sigma k goes from 1 to 6 sine 2 pi k upon 30. Okay, that completes our today's assignment. Show me these answers.